Here's a problem we've identified in the man lab, and I bet millions of you have done it at home, in the office, in the garden, in your own workshop. I made a cup of tea, and I knew I hadn't finished it, because you always know when you've still got half a cup of tea left, but I've put it somewhere and forgotten where it is. And after a while, I remembered that actually it was over here, look, because I came over to help these guys do something on the Swiss Army bicycle. And now, as a result of that, that has gone completely stone cold and is undrinkable. And this is an interesting point, because the British government's waste watchdog reckons that about £110 million is wasted every year by people throwing away half-drunk cold cups of tea. And another £100 or so million is wasted making another cup of tea when you already had a perfectly good one. So, me and Simi have come up with what we think is a rather brilliant idea. It's a teacup that incorporates a temperature-sensitive alarm that will sound a piercing squeal when the tea falls below a given temperature, which we're going to work out, not only warning you to drink it, but also telling you where it is, because if it's over there and you've put it on a shelf like that while you're doing something, it'll go beep, and you think, tea, going cold, over there. What we will have to establish by careful and scientific experimentation is the temperature at which tea has become too cold to drink.
For the benefit of overseas viewers, you should know that any mention of tea in a British male laboratory instantly brews up a massive argument.
The best way to make a cup of tea is to make it in the mug.
Says who?
She said.
Scientists. Tea scientists.
Even though there is a lot of social stigma attached to it, I still think the milk should go in first.
Milk goes in last in the cup.
No, but I think that spoils the taste. Because if you've got a large volume of tea and you add the cold milk, the milk is scalded by the tea.
I make it in the mug, put the milk in last.
Yeah, that's my boy.
But if the milk is in the cup first, the tea is added to it gradually and heats it up gently so it doesn't change the molecular structure of the milk and it tastes better.
If you put the tea into the cup, the temperature of the cup will take away some of the heat from the tea, so it won't be boiling when you add the milk, so the milk won't get scalded and ruin the taste.
Yes, but you've still got, even in a fairly small cup, at least you've got a massive volume of hot tea, and as we know from the first and second law of thermodynamics, it won't pass from the cooler to the hotter. That volume of heat has that small volume of milk to heat up, whereas if you pour the tea into the milk, the cameraman's given up.
Anyway.
Eventually, we managed to coax our cameraman back with the promise of a nice hot cup of tea. Milk first. Right, back to our alarm. We're using an old thermometer, which we will attach to the bottom of the mug. The thermometer's needle is attached to a bimetallic strip, two pieces of metal that coil or uncoil in reaction to heat.
We can demonstrate this using this hot air machine that we've found.
Can you see it moving?
Yeah.
Hey!
Look at that.
Inside our reappropriated thermometer, we're putting a battery and a buzzer.
We will connect the little wire, one end back.
The needle will be attached to the battery and the buzzer in an electrical circuit.
As it cools.
So, when the temperature in the tea drops to almost undrinkable levels, the needle will complete the circuit, setting off the buzzer.
Whoa! Your tea is getting cold.
That's perfect, isn't it? Champion.
The difficulty with a teacup alarm is that, like Ronnie Corbett with a violin, it's incredibly small and fiddly. But as Charles Dickens, 1812 to 1870, said, "My dear, if you would give me a cup of tea, I should better understand your affairs."
Want some tea?
With final calibrations calibrated and wires wired, there's only one thing left to do.
Right, now for the test. This is prototype number one. It's been calibrated, 56, 57 degrees. I'm going to make a cup of tea in it by the builder's method, i.e. tea bag in the cup. Just boiled that. Lovely. And then I'm going to go back to my woodworking job that I was doing earlier. Simi is going to hide my cup of tea somewhere in the man lab, and I'll wait for it to warn me that it's not been drunk. You'll have to do the milk bit.
And take the tea bag out.
And take the tea bag out, yeah. It's now just coming up for 10 minutes since Sim hid the cup of tea. It is amazing what you can achieve in the time it takes a cup of tea to become too cold to drink. I've reduced most of this superb piece of wood to sawdust. Ah. Is it... Yes, it is. See, I'd never have found that. That's it. Obviously, in the final version, we're going to have to incorporate a switch, because now it's going to buzz constantly, and it will buzz when we put the cup away in the cupboard as well, so we do need a switch in it, Simmy. But other than that, what a brilliant idea. Mmm. Perfectly drinkable. Life improved by Manlab. It's actually a terrible cup of tea, Simmy.
You weren't supposed to drink it.
Tastes of solder.
It's got... There's probably a few little metal filings and... Don't drink it all. It's work in progress, James.